got mugged.
Zach did. They all do. The boys, that is.
It's as if they're a little window of opportunity, where the bigger boys can pounce. Like when crabs shed the shells, and all the birds are just waiting.
This man stood in front of me, told me to give him my bike. So he did, just like that.
Some bigger boys just walked up to him and his friends. Broad daylight, you know.
This boy asked me the time, so I took out my phone.
To what was in their pockets? They just let them, rather than lose face, make a fuss.
I said, good boy, something's just on with fighting over.
She's not fat, I'll say that straight off. But she's not thin either. Not like some of the skinny, skinny ones. I tell her, it doesn't matter. At their age, your body's changing all the time, and what a person looks like is a very small part of who they are. I can see she doesn't believe me. I don't believe myself sometimes, but it's what you meant to say. My husband used to tell me I was beautiful, and I used to think, what are you? A liar or just stupid? In the end, it made me hate him.
We have a tiny little unit. We've not had much choice with the dad out of the picture. So when I was diagnosed, I just told them I'd had a test that said I'd need an operation, and that operation would be in 10 days' time. I told them I wasn't going to die. I felt pretty confident about that. We caught it very early, and my doctor seemed really positive. So I told them that it seemed important just to say it. I'd asked them if they had any questions they wanted me to ask the doctor, because I had questions too. And if we pulled our questions, we might understand the illness better. Zach didn't ask anything. Nadia asked two things. What colour is the tumour? And if they take it out, can I have it?
He hates us at the minute. Really hates us. I look on his computer. There was a problem for a while with what he was watching. I had to talk to him about it. I had to tell him, this is nothing like the real world. This isn't what real women look like. Those women aren't enjoying it. They're just doing it to pay for a drug habit or feed the children. I check his search history. I tell him, if you've cleared it, I'll just assume that's what you've been doing, and we'll be having this conversation all over again.
So last summer, one day, she came back in a rare old state. This is Jasmine again. I hardly need to say. She could hardly breathe to get her words out. They'd been caught shoplifting, Darcy and Jenny Rose. I knew they were going to do it, so I went next door to Boots. It was a proper saga. Parents were down at the police station, and the girls were banned from H&M. That's all that happened in the end. But I had to have the talk with Jasmine. I had to say, all right, let me tell you, if you'd been caught, it wouldn't have been the same. It would have been a completely different outcome. And this is why. Because you're black, and you need to learn this lesson. You would have been treated completely differently. You always will be.
I know I'm hard on him. Well, he thinks I'm hard on him. But you've got to draw the line. I'm just not always sure the line's in the right place.
So I called a meeting in Costa with the other mums. I said, I'm sorry, I really like your girls, but when my daughter's with them, when they're all together, there's something goes wrong. So my daughter won't be coming to your house again, and your children are no longer welcome in my home. I've never regretted that. You want them to learn the lessons that actions have consequences, but they can be very hard lessons.
I'm spending my our lives, before we had the boys, if they knew, it would kill them. Drugs, for example. We've taken just about everything. Both of us. I've never told them that. I don't want to endorse that sort of behaviour. I mean, we don't do it now, and I don't think it did us any harm back then. But they've got to understand that it's not behaviour that I approve of. I think it's dangerous behaviour.
I deliberately don't even ask, I'll be honest. I'd rather not know who's this, who's that, how long have you known them. To be honest, there's a distance between them. And I quite like it. We respect each other's boundaries. Once in the kitchen I found a lighter. And I wondered about it. But I just left it alone and it disappeared. I think that's my policy, really. Do nothing if you can, and things just tend to resolve themselves. I still don't know whose lighter it was.
If I'm honest, I've noticed myself competing with them more. We'd always done running races in the park, but I started to make the distances shorter, so I could still beat them.
I like the thing he still needs us. I don't know if it's true. The old thing, and he'll ask for a lift sometimes. And actually, he's just being lazy. He doesn't want to walk. But I go. And I'm glad to go, because how many more chances will there be? Thanks, Dad, he says. But I'm not doing it for him. I'm doing it for me. I think more about my dad now. You do that. You think more about your parents when you're older. And they're not around anymore.
Get up, come on, you're going to miss it.
For the last time, you just go to bed.
Go out, get some fresh air.
I want you back in the house, Dad.
You're not still doing that.
Haven't you even started yet? You need to eat something.
Who's eating all this?
You need to work harder.
You wear yourself out.
You've got to take it seriously.
Hey, it's not the end of the world.
For years, I was so jealous of parents who kept the room the same for them. The old posters on the walls even. Because honestly, mine, well, they just couldn't disguise how excited they were. To be losing a daughter, but to be gaining an ensuite. So now I just feel totally guilty. Because if I'm honest, I really badly want them out. All of them. I can't wait.
He doesn't ever want to talk about his birth family. All the time in care. He can remember it. That life. Of course. He'll never forget it. But he keeps it to himself. It's left him bad with change. Uncertainty. He worries. He still hasn't called. Sometimes I think if he did to us what we did to him, just kept him hanging in the dark, his world would just collapse.
Once or twice. I've admitted to something. From when I got it wrong, round about their age. They're shocked. They can't handle it. They think they know everything about you. You're the one thing in the world they know everything about. That doesn't change. It can't compute when you need to do stuff that doesn't go with that picture. Now I think they want you to lie. They lie too, of course. It's how we all protect each other.
Thank you.
Something I got given at a club. Judge you any time, day or night. You call me, and I'll sort it out.
I asked him, show me how to get the iPod play through the speakers. He laughed at me. And then he did it really fast, so I couldn't say how. Now I've got to ask him again.
When I was growing up, all I wanted was to get away. It's not that I didn't love my parents, but I hated that whole extended family thing you get in immigrant communities. I needed to get out, get on. I know they've got a separate from you, but I can't bear the idea of slowly drifting away.
She's not getting on with her mum. I mean, occasionally there's a glimmer of some kind of bonding, but mostly they are at each other's throats. I'm the mediator. I try not to lose me temper, and I didn't even know I had a temper till I met Kira. She's quite a forceful character. When she was two, I would use hostage negotiation techniques with her, but she'd still make mincemeat of us. She can still turn the tables now. I mean, a mum cannot do anything right. But if she was now here with you, she'd be absolutely charming.
When I told them I was having chemo, Zach asked if my hair would fall out, and I said yes. In that we had it first, but you mustn't be frightened. It won't be forever. He said, I never ever want to be seen out with you in public with no hair. I said,